Hey traders, welcome back to this channel. In today's video, I want to show you how do you prepare for the trading day, or otherwise, in our case, the trading week. We generally do this once a week. And in today's video, I want to show you the process that we do every single week to prepare ourselves to trade the market. Okay, you should know by now that all professional traders prepare they prepare in one way or another, whether is it at the start of the, start of the trading session or at the start of the trading week, they all prepare, okay? Because you need to know your levels before you start trading. You need to know your biases and other things such as the economic data and all this stuff before you start trading, okay? So what separates retail traders from professional traders is preparation. So if you are not already preparing, then hopefully this video will give you an insight as to how we prepare for our trading week. And hopefully you can model after what we do and incorporate this into your trading. So this is what I'm going to be covering today. I want to show you the first thing that we always do. Okay, week in and week out, we do this every single week without fail. Okay, this is the first thing that you need to do. Okay, not just for ourselves. We think that it's very important that you do this. Okay, it doesn't matter what strategy that you're doing, you need to be doing this. Okay, so that's the first thing that I'll cover. The next thing I want to cover is I want to show you how we use the DXY. Okay, DXY stands for the dollar index. Okay, I want to help you understand why we use DXY. What does DXY mean? Why we're actually looking at it, and I just want to break it down for you. And then lastly, I want to show you how we identify key levels of interest, key levels that we want to watch for trade setups, all right, with charts. Okay, I want to go straight into the charts and show you some currency pairs and kind of walk you through how we analyze the charts today. Okay, so today is actually Sunday, so we are preparing for the next trading week ahead. Okay, but irregardless of which trading week it is always the same process. Okay, the news might be different, the economic data might be different, but the process is always the same. Okay, you need to have a proven process, and only when you have a proven process which you stick to day in and day out, then can you be consistent as a trader. So that's what I'm trying to give you today. I'm trying to give you this process that we are using. Okay, so hopefully you write some notes and you do it after you watch this video. Now, by the way, please give us a thumbs up, right? We really appreciate it if you like this video and you subscribe to our channel. Okay, we have a lot of trading videos to help you become a better trader. We also have a free day trading guide. So the link's in the description, just download that as and when you are free. Okay, just have a look at it, right? There's a lot of good materials inside that that we have compiled for you. If not, let's go into today's video. Okay, so what is the first thing that we always do without fail? Okay, the answer is very simple. We always look at the Forex calendar. Okay, so there are many Forex calendars out there, or otherwise known as the economic calendar. So what the economic calendar does is that it gives you the economic data for the week. Okay, but the Forex calendar that we use mostly is the forexfactory.com calendar. Okay, in a moment's time, I'm going to show you forexfactory.com just to walk you through how this calendar works. Okay, you want to focus on the high impact news, means that the news which are red in color. If you are using Forex Factory, then it will be red in color. So let me just jump over quickly to the Forex Factory and show you how it is. Okay, so right now I'm at Forex Factory. Let me just change it. Okay, so right now I'm at forexfactory.com. So you can see that this is the calendar for next week. Okay, so what you can do is you can toggle around the weeks. So if you are not looking at the current week, then you can just change it. So in this case, I'm already looking at the next trading week ahead, which is 24th August. So what you can do is you can do the filter. So you can filter out just by the red logo over here. Okay, or whatever you call this, the red one. So red means a high impact, orange means medium impact, and yellow means low impact. Okay, for my case, I'm just going to leave it all on. But what you want to focus on is you want to focus on the red ones. So you can see that next week we have a retail sales Kiwi. We have this one, Federal Reserve Chairman Powell is going to speak at 9 p.m. You have Jackson Hole. So this will give you an insight as to what currencies are going to move and also help you to predict the kind of market condition that you're going to expect. So looking at this week, when we have this kind of Jackson Hole, this kind of lot of speeches, the market is going to be very whippy. So this is how we predict the market condition. Okay, if you are new to this channel and you do not know all this, we cover a lot of all these kind of concepts in our Forex trading course. Okay, our Forex trading course is also free. The link's in the description, just check it out, right? You just need to open an account with our sponsoring brokerage to get access to all our materials and our Forex signals. Okay, but next week is looking as though it's going to be a very whippy week. So this is what we always do. We look at the Forex calendar to give us an insight as to how the market's going to move next week. Okay, of course, this is just a kind of like a prediction. It may not actually move like that, but it's always good for you to understand what currencies are going to move and what kind of markets we are dealing with. Okay, so this is the first thing we do. Now, the second thing that we do is that we always look at the DXY. So what is DXY? Let me just, you know, do a brief breakdown of it first. Then I'll go into the actual charts, okay? So what is DXY? DXY is the dollar index, okay? The ticker name is called DXY, but it stands for dollar index. So why should you be focusing on DXY? If you are not currently looking at DXY, you want to be paying attention to DXY, okay? You need to be paying attention to it because USD is the main currency, okay? US dollar is the main currency. No, in currency trading in Forex, dollar is the biggest currency. So you need to pay attention to the biggest. Okay. Another cool tip I have for you is that the euro moves inversely to DXY. So that means that if DXY is down, that means euro is up, euro dollar is up. So it's also a good form of a signal to tell you the direction of euro. So by studying the DXY, you can not only predict the direction of dollar, but you can also predict the direction of euro. And here's the very powerful thing about really understanding DXY and why it's so important, is that if you can predict the direction of DXY, which is essentially dollar because it's dollar index, it is very easy for you to trade the FX majors because the FX majors are all packed with the dollar. So FX major consists of currency pairs such as, you know, euro dollar, dollar CAD, pound dollar, dollar yen, you know, Aussie dollar, Kiwi dollar. So basically anything packed with dollar. So if you can identify the direction of dollar, then you can easily trade these currencies. So it'll be very easy. Right here, I also have a breakdown of what does DXY consist of. So you can see over here that this DXY has about 57. Half of it is euro, meaning that the index is one. The summation of all the currencies is one, meaning that it's one whole. And this is a ratio of 0.576. So more than half of the DXY is made of euro. And that is why euro also moves inversely to DXY. Whenever DXY is dropping, that means euro is going up. So hopefully that's clear. To be honest, you do not need to know these components. It's not necessary. But what I want to impress upon you today is that you need to be paying attention to DXY. You need to look at DXY and you need to learn to see the direction of DXY if you want to be trading. Okay. The first thing we do is look at the Forex calendar. The second thing that we do is we look at DXY. Okay, so now let's go into the charts and show you how we identify key levels. Okay, so in this case, since I've mentioned that you should be looking at DXY, I've put out the DXY chart over here. So the first thing we do is look at the Forex calendar. Second thing is look at DXY. And when we are looking at DXY, we want to find out the key levels. We want to find out the biases for DXY. Now, by the way, we have a very simple strategy that works. It's called the MPE trading strategy. And that is the trading strategy that is taught in our three-day trading guide. So if you have not downloaded that, the link is in the description. So make sure you download that so that you can apply it to your charts. So the first thing we want to do when we look at DXY is we want to identify the key support and resistance levels. So in this case, we are on the daily chart, you can see, and I would recommend you to start on the daily chart. Do not go into the H4, do not go into the H1. Okay, because you are trying to prepare for the trading week ahead. So you want to keep your levels on the higher time frame, which is in my case, the daily chart. So I can see that there's some form of support here because this was the prior swing low. And it looks like there is kind of like a left shoulder, head and right shoulder forming. Of course, it's still too early to say, but I just want to map out this as support and I have a resistance somewhere around here. So you can see that price was resisted here and resisted here again. So now that we have our levels, we can kind of make a form of a prediction that, okay, price is supported at 92.71 level right now and there's a resistance at 93.77 level. So that would mean that going into next week, we will expect dollar to strengthen to about this level. And that would mean that we can look at currency pairs such as euro dollar. We can look to short euro dollar, short pound dollar, short Aussie dollar, short Kiwi dollar, or long dollar CAD. So this is how we use it. But of course, you do not just want to stop at a DXY. You still want to go into your other currency pairs. Like let's say you want to trade the euro dollar. You still want to go in your euro dollar and you will still want to plot out your main levels, okay? Switch to the daily chart and plot your main support and resistance level, okay? Now, a quick tip for you is that if you cannot see the levels, you cannot identify your support or resistance levels correctly or accurately, just switch to the line chart. You should be able to find it very easily. Just take the turning points, the major turning points. So in this case, there's this level here as well. And this one, I'll just leave it as this level here and then change back to the candlestick chart. And then there you have your level. So in this case, euro dollar, you can see that it follows the DXY because our analysis for DXY was that DXY is going to strengthen. That means dollar is going to be strengthening. That means euro dollar is going to be dropping. So in this case, you can see that this is indeed true. Price is resisted at 1.1855 region and price seems to be dropping towards 1.1710 level. So this is how we use it. And of course, what you want to do as the trading week is starts or resumes, the market's open, you want to look for a trigger to start selling towards this level, or you want to look for a buy entry at this level. Okay, so you want to identify the key levels, and then as the market comes to you and the market moves to this level, you look for a trigger. Okay, you can use our MPE trading strategy to enter your trades, but in today's video, I just want to focus on the kind of preparation that we do for the trading week. So hopefully that is clear. If you have any questions, just let us know. We'll be happy to address it. But let me just go back to the PowerPoint slide. Let me just do a recap of what I covered today. Okay, so in today's training video, I share with you the first thing that we always do. We go to forexfactory.com to see the economic data. Okay, we try to understand what currency is going to be moving, what kind of market are we in. Okay, if there's a lot of conferences, then we expect the market to be very whippy. But if there are just a lot of hard economic data, such as like unemployment rates, retail sales and all this kind of data, then the market's probably going to be more smooth sailing. And the second thing that we do is that we look at DXY. Okay, I explain to you what DXY, I break it down for you, share with you why you should be looking at DXY. I also share with you the components of DXY. But the most important thing that you need to take away from this portion is that DXY is something that you need to be looking into every single week. Okay, before you start your trading week, look at DXY and try to understand where is dollar headed. Okay, that's the first thing you want to do. And then the last thing that I shared to review today is that you want to identify the key levels of interest on your charts. Okay, don't just do it for DXY, but do it for euro dollar or any currency pair that you want to trade. Okay, you always want to map out your territory, where's the support, where's the resistance, so that when the market hits these levels during the trading week, you are really well prepared. You really have an idea about what you want to do at which level. Okay, you are not reacting to the market, but you are waiting for price to come to your level. Okay, so that's how you should approach your trading. Okay, so as always, if you have any questions, just feel free to leave a comment down below. We love to help you. Okay, at the same time, please really appreciate if you could just give us a thumbs up. It doesn't take you more than 3 seconds. Just give us a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button. Turn on the notification bell so that you will receive every single video update that we have. Okay, we create a video almost every single day for you to help serve you and help you become a better trader. Now, if you have not downloaded our free day trade guide, just make sure to do that. If not, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.